गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? एवरीवन ओके? ओके, सो व्हाट हैड वी स्टडीड इन आवर प्रीवियस क्लास? वी हैड स्टडीड अबाउट क्यूब एंड क्यूब रूट्स, राइट? सो क्यूब एंड क्यूब रूट्स मींस इन दैट वी हैड स्टडीड हाउ टू फाइंड द क्यूब ऑफ अ गिवन नंबर एंड हाउ टू फाइंड द क्यूब रूट ऑफ अ गिवन नंबर. ओके, विद मैन्युअली ऑल्सो वी सॉ हाउ टू फाइंड द क्यूब रूट एंड वी used the calculator also. We saw how to use the calculator and to solve questions based on cube and cube root. Okay, so that was about and in before that we had studied about square and square roots, right? So that was only about the power raised to 2 and 3, right? The power, that means any number was given to us. Okay, any number, suppose 2, if that number is given to us, we found its square or we found its cube, right? Any numbers, we found it, the cube root, the square and the cube of the given number, right? That means the power which was raised to that number was 2 or 3. Here this power is 2 and this is 3. So 2 means what? It is a square, and 3 means what? It is a cube, right? But if a number is raised to the power which is greater than 3, okay, if it is greater than 3, that is greater than cube, then what we have to do, we won't say that it is a square or it is a cube, right? We call it just the power of the given number, okay? So power of the given number can be anything. It can be 4, or it can be, means it can be 2 raised to 4, or it can be 2 raised to 10, or it can be 2 raised to 100, 1000, 90, how much, like it can be anything, okay? So we will see now how to write the numbers which are multiplied to itself a number of times, okay? How to write it in index notation, that is called as index notation. Why? Because the number which is raised to some number, this number which we write up here is called the index. Okay, it is called an index. Okay, so we will see how to write a given number in its index notation, or the multiplication of the given number in its index notation. So let's go to exercise 1H. The first question is, write each of these using index notation. So we have to write these numbers in its index notation. So here in the first example, you can see that the number 3 is multiplied to itself in how many times? Some number of times. Okay, so we will count. So which number is multiplied here? 3 is multiplied to itself. Okay, the number which is being multiplied has to be multiplied by itself only. Only then we can write its index notation. Okay, so here the number 3 is getting multiplied to itself how many times? Let us count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So the number 3 is multiplied to itself 5 times. So how do we write this in the index notation? First we write the number 3. Okay. We write number 3 because the number 3 is getting multiplied. And how many times is it getting multiplied? We counted. How many times? It was 5 times. So that 5, number 5, where we write it like this. Okay. This is the index notation, because 5 is called as the index and 3 is called as the base. Okay, so when we write a number like in this form, 3 raised to 5, that means the number 3, the base, is getting multiplied to itself these many number of times. Okay, so here 3 is getting multiplied to itself 5 number of times. Okay, everyone has understood this is very simple to write in the index notation. Okay, and if we want to find this value, what is this value? Okay, we can do it by two ways. We can multiply this 3 to itself 5 times. We can do 3 into 3 is 9, 9 into 3 is 27. Then again 27 into 3, whatever the answer gets, we can do it like this. Or we can even do it directly, 3 raised to 5, by using a calculator. So, in this, in the previous class, we had studied how to find the cube of a given number, right? So there I had told you by using a calculator, how do we do it? We press a key which was x raised to 3, right? To find the cube of a number, we pressed the key of x raised to 3. But if any number is other than 2 and 3, then how do we find the value? Okay, then how do we do the calculation? That I will tell you now. Okay, so here the number 3 is raised to 5. So to find the value of this number, what will be 3 multiplied to itself 5 times? To find the answer of this, what do we do? We'll see how to find it on the calculator. So first key which I press will be the number which I am multiplying. Okay, so first I press 3. So I press 3 first. Then after that, I press in this calculator which I have told you, or I have sent you a picture also of this. So in this calculator, the raised to sign, there is a key which is for the index number. Okay, so that key is this. It looks like this. Okay. So, if we have to write any number which is given to us raised to 5, then what we do, if we want to find the answer of this, we first press the number key of 3, then we press raised to sign. So, now I press the raised to sign, okay? And then I press the number which is raised to, what is the power which is there, okay? So, here the power is 5, or the index is 5. So, now I press 5. And then equal to. So the answer is 243. So which keys did I press? First I press 3. Then I press the raised to sign. This is called the raised to sign. Okay. Raised to 5. Which number is there? Which number is raised? 5 is raised. Okay. So 3 raised to 5 is equal to. Okay. So these keys we have to press. So 3 raised to 5. The answer we get 243. So here the answer is 243. Okay, now we go to the, we can leave this sum as it is 3 raised to 5, or if the, in the question, if they have asked us to find the value of the answer, we can even find the value, okay, by using a calculator also it is okay. So now we go to the second example. The second example here, which number is getting multiplied? 5 is getting multiplied, okay, so I write 5 as my base. And how many times is it getting multiplied? Let's count. How many times? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So it is getting multiplied 8 times. So what will be the power of 5? Or the index will be 8. Why? This means what? 5 is getting multiplied to itself 8 times. Okay. So now I find the value of this. What is 5 raised to 8? When I multiply 5 to itself 8 times, what I get the answer? So first I press number 5. Then I press the raised to sign. Then I press 8, okay, and then equal to. So this answer which I have got is 390625. Okay, so 5 raised to itself 3 times, 8 times, 5 multiplied by itself 8 times gives me 390625. Okay, so for this, which keys did I press? I pressed 5 first, then the raised to sign, then 8, and then equal to. Okay. So, this was the first question. Now we go to the second question. The second question is, using the power key on your calculator, work out. That means you have to use the power key. Power key means this key which we have used here, okay? So, here we saw how to find the power, right? The number raised to some power. So, similarly, here also we have to find the answer of this number raised to power 4, this number raised to power 5, okay? Only the difference here is that the numbers are in decimal points, okay? So first, what will I do? Which keys will I press? First, I will press the number. So what is the number? It is 3.2, right? So to write 3.2, I will first press 3, then I press point, then 2, then raised to, then which number is it raised to? 4, okay? So I press 4 and then equal. So let's find this value. So this is 3.2 raised to 4 equal. So the answer which I have got is 104.8576. Okay. So 3.2 raised to 4, that means 3.2 multiplied by itself 4 times. This means what? The number 3.2 is multiplied to itself 4 times. So, when we multiply 3.2 to itself 4 times, we get 104.8576. Okay, now we go to the second question. The second question, the number is 1.3 and it is multiplied to itself how many times? 5 times. So the index is 5. So here which keys will I press? I will press 1 first, then I will press point, then 3, raised to 5 and then equal to. So let's see what is the answer of this. 1.3 raised to the power 5 is equal to. So the answer is 3.71293. Okay. So, we have seen here, this was all about exercise 1H. It's a very simple exercise. Any number which is raised to any number. That means, let the number be 3 or any number. We can take any number which is raised to any power. Okay. We can find the answer of it by using a calculator very easily. Okay. So, this was index notation. And then we saw how to find the value of some numbers raised to some powers. Okay. So, this was about exercise 1H. Now, we will go to the next part. The lowest common multiple. Okay. Lowest common multiple means the smallest multiple of two numbers. Okay. The common multiple which is the smallest of all of given two numbers. You will come to know when we solve the examples. Okay. And the second thing is HCF. HCF means what? The highest common factor. Okay. So, how to find the highest common factor and the lowest common multiple of given two numbers or three numbers, that we are going to see in this exercise 1I. Okay. So, first we will see the question number 1, which is find the LCM for each number. Okay. LCM means, I've told you, LCM means the lowest common multiple. Okay. So, I'll write here LCM means what? Lowest common multiple. Okay. The lowest common multiple. So, we have to find the LCM, the lowest common multiple of both these numbers 3 and 7. So, the first thing which we have to do, and let me tell you one thing, this LCM, it is important for us to find the LCM when we do fractions, okay? When we do the addition or subtraction of fractions, that time we need to find the LCM of the given fraction, okay? LCM of the denominator. So, in that we need this. So, we will see how to find the LCM of two numbers. So, first what we have to check is, we have to check if both the numbers are prime numbers or if one number can be divided by the other number. So, here we can see in the first question, the numbers are 3 and 7. Here we can see that both the numbers are prime numbers. Okay, prime numbers means they are not multiples of any other number. Okay, that means any number when we multiplied to some number, we won't get 3. Right, any number if we multiply to some other number, we don't get 3. And 7 is also a prime number. Means it is not a multiple of any other number. Okay. So, that means in any numbers table, 7 doesn't come. Except for 7. And in 3 also. 3 doesn't come in any other table except for its own table. Okay. So, the two numbers which are given to us are 3 and 7. First, what we do, we write the multiples of both the numbers. Multiples means what? When we multiply 3 to 1, we get 3. 3 to 2, we get 6. So, like that, we have to multiply 3 to all the numbers and we have to write their multiples, okay? So, we write multiples of multiples of 3. So, what are the multiples of 3? 3 1s are 3, 3 2s are 6, 3 3s are 9, 3 4s are 12, 3 5s are 15, 3 6s are 18, 3 7s are 21, 3 8s are 24, 3 9s are 27, 3 10s are 30, 3 11s are 33, 3 12s are 36, and so on. Okay? So this will continue to infinity. Why? Because the numbers which are there, numbers are infinite. So we can go on multiplying number 3 to further numbers like 13, 14, 15, 16. Okay? So we can go on multiplying. Now we see the multiples of 7, the second number which is given to us. Multiples of 7. Multiples means what? In short, we have to write the table of the given number. Okay? Up to certain extent. Like we can write the up to 12 multiplied by 12 or multiplied by 13 or till whatever extent we want. But the numbers should be quite large. Okay? Large means there should be more numbers. So now we see the multiples of 7. So 7 ones are 7, 7 twos are 14, 7 threes are 21, 7 fours are 28, 7 fives are 35, 7 sixes are 42, 7 sevens are 49, 7 eights are 56, 7 nines are 63, 7 tens are 70, 7 elevens are 77, and so on. Okay? So these numbers will go on increasing. Now, from these multiples, we have to find the common multiples. Okay? So which are the common multiples of 3 and 7? These are the multiples of 3 and these are the multiples of 7. So which are common between them? Those we have to jot. Okay. So now we jot down the common multiples which are there. So we write the common multiples. So, which are the common multiples from these? Is 3 there? No. Then we can see that the first common multiple is 21. Okay. So, this 21 I circle. Then 24, 27 is not there. 30, 33, 36 and all. Then 3 into 12 is 36. Now, let's check 3 into 13. How much is 3 into 30? 3, 13, 9, 39, 40, 41, 42. So after 36 we have 39, then we have 42, and then so on. Okay, so now after 21 the next common which is there, common number which is there between these two is 42. Okay, so I circle 42 also. So, I have got up till now the numbers, the multiples which I have written, from those I have got common multiples. The first one is 21 and the second one is 42. And if we go on multiplying these numbers further, we will get more common multiples. Okay. But for now, we have taken only two common multiples. And from that, so these multiples are starting from which number? It is starting from 21. Right. So, the number which is smallest of all is 21. The lowest. Okay. The lowest number is 21. So, this is our lowest common multiple. These are the common multiples. And lowest out of all is 21. So, 21 is the lowest common multiple. So, I write the lowest common multiple of 3 and 7. 3 and 7 is how much? 21. Okay. So, this was a longer procedure of finding the multiples of 3 and 7. I'll tell you a short method to find the LCM of two numbers. So, if two numbers are given and if we have to find the least common multiple, that is the LCM of those two numbers, first we have to check that if they are multiples of each other. That means, does 7 come in 3's table? If we multiply any number by 3, do we get 7? No. And if we multiply any number by any number to 7, do we get 3? No. So 3 and 7 are not multiples of each other, right? Okay. Multiplying any number to the given two numbers does not give me the numbers which are there here. Okay. So if it is like this, if it is this case that the two numbers are not multiples of each other, then the LCM of these two numbers is their multiplication. How? Let's see. So here the two numbers are 3 and 7. Now if I multiply 3 to 7, how much do I get? 3 into 7 is? 3 sevens are 21. Right? So this is my LCM which I've got correct. 21. Okay? So if the two numbers which are given to us are not multiples of each other. Okay? Are not multiples of each other means 3 multiplied to some number does not give me 7. And 7 multiplied to any number does not give me 3. That means in short, in 3's table, 7 doesn't come. And 7's table, 3 doesn't come. Okay? So if the numbers are such, then their multiplication will give us the LCM of the two numbers. Okay? So this is a shorter way to find the LCM. Now we will go to the second example. Okay? Now we see how to find the LCM of 4 and 9. Now here we can see that 4 in 4's table, does 9 come in 4's table? No. If we multiply any number by 4, does 9 come? No. And if we multiply any number 9, any number to 9, does 4 come? No. So that means 4 and 9 are not multiples of each other. So first we will find in the regular way, in the way we find the LCM of two given numbers, okay? So first I write the multiples of 4. The first number is 4. So I write the multiples of 4. So what are the multiples of 4? 4 ones are 4, 4 twos are 8. Sorry. 4 twos are 8, 4 threes are 12, 4 fours are 16, 4 fives are 20, 4 six are 24, 4 sevens are 28, 4 eights are 32. 4 9s are 36, 4 10s are 40, 4 11s are 44, 4 12s are 48, then 4 13s are how much? 4 3s are 12, 4 5, 4 into 13 is how much? 13, 4, 4 3s are 12, 4 5, so 52, then comes after 52, 14 into 4 is 5, 56, then comes 60, then 64, then 68, then 72, then 76, right? Is this correct? 4, 8, 12, 16, 20, 24, 28, 32, 36, 40, 44, 48, 40, 52, 56, 60, 64, 68, 72, 76. Okay. And then it goes on continuing. Okay. So these all are the multiples of 4. Now I write the multiples of the other number. The other number is 9. So multiples of 9. How much are, what are the multiples of 9? 9 ones are 9, 9 twos are 18, 9 threes are 20, 9 threes are 27, then 9 fours are 36, 9 fours are 36, 9 fives are 40, 9 sevens are 63, 9 eights are 72, 9 nines are 81, 9 tens are 90, 9 elevens are 99, and so on. Okay? So, all these are the multiples, and further also, these are the multiples of number 9. Now, I write the common multiples of both the numbers. So, common multiples of 4 and 9. So, which are the common multiples? Here let's check the first common multiple, which is 18 there? No, 27, no, 36, yes, 36 is there. So, 36 is the first one. Okay, so I write 36. Then the next one is 72. Okay, so 72 is the next common multiple. And if we multiply then these numbers further, we will get further common multiples. Okay? So, these all are the common multiples of 4 and 9. Right? And the least or the lowest is 36. Okay? So, the LCM of 4 and 9 is what? 36. So, this is the longer way or the lengthy method to find the LCM of two given numbers, okay? And the shorter method which I told you was just to multiply the two numbers, and that will be the LCM of the two numbers. So let's check what is 4 into 9. 4 nines are 36, right? So 36 is the least common multiple. Here we have found it out. the number is 36, and here also we have seen that the multiplication of two numbers is 36, and 36 is the least common multiple. Okay, so in this way we can find, this is the short way of finding the LCM of two numbers. Okay, so this is it. This was the procedure to find the LCM of two given numbers. Now we go to the second question. The second question is, find the HCF of these pair of numbers. Here we have to find the HCF. HCF means what? The highest common factor. Okay, so I write HCF is highest common factor. So we have to find the highest common factor of these two numbers. So the procedure or the way in which we find the highest common factor is, first we write both the numbers 18 and 12. Okay? And we go on dividing these numbers. Okay? But we have to divide both the numbers by only one number which gets divided by both the numbers. That means it will get divided by 18 also and by 12 also. So we have to find such a number that it will get divided to 18 also and 12 also. So first, we start with the lowest number except 1. So leave 1 and start from 2. So let's see. Does 18 get divided by 2? Yes. Is 12 divided by 2? Yes. So I write 2 into how much is 18? 2 into 9 is 18. And 2 into 6 is 12. Okay. So I write 9 below 18 and 6 below 12. Because 2 into 9 is 18. 2 into 6 is 12. Okay. Now we see the next two numbers which we have got. So the two numbers which we have got now are 3, 9 and 6. So which is the number which can be multiplied to both the numbers? Sorry, divided by both the numbers. So which number? Can 2 be divided? No, 9 does not get divided by 2. Right? That means in 2's table, 9 doesn't come. Right? So, we check the next number. After 2, which number comes? 3. Okay? So, we take 3. Because 9 can also be divided by 3 and 6 also can be divided by 3. So, we write 3 here. 3 into how much is 9? 3 into 3 is 9. And 3 into how much is 6? 3 into 2 is 6. Now, the next two numbers which we have got here, 3 and 2, cannot be further divided by any common number. Okay? Neither 2, neither 3 can be divided by any common number. So, we keep this as it is. Only 1 will be the common factor. 1 into 3 will give me 3 and 1 into 2 will give me 2. But we don't take 1 normally. Okay, so 1 is the common factor of all the numbers. 1 is the common factor. Any number multiplied to 1 will be that number only, right? 3 into 1 gives me 3 only. 2 into 1 gives me 2. So we don't take 1 as the factor. Okay, so we take all the numbers except 1. So here which numbers have we got? We have got 3, 2 and 3. So the numbers which we have got here, we have to multiply them. So I multiply 2 and 3. So what is 2 into 3? 6. So this is my highest common factor of the given two numbers 18 and 12. So in this way we find the highest common factor of given two numbers. Similarly, we can find the highest common factor of three numbers. Only the condition for this is the number to which we are dividing. Okay, the number by which we are dividing the numbers should be common. The number 2 is common to 18 also, 12 also. 3 is common to 9 also and 6 also. So the number by which we are dividing should be common to the given numbers. Okay, so that is the condition. Now we go to the second example. In the second example, 36 and 48. We have to find the HCF of 36 and 48. So first I write the two numbers 36, 48. And now let's start dividing these two numbers by the common factor. Okay. So, take the smallest number. The smallest number is 2. So, I multiplied by 2. 2 ones are 2. 2 8s are 16. That means 2 into 18 gives me 36. and 2 into 24 gives me 48. Okay. Now 2 into 9 gives me 18 and 2 into 12 gives me 24. Now we see which numbers have we got, 9 and 12. Now 9 does not go in 2 table. That means this number, for these two numbers, 2 cannot be the common factor. So we take 3. 3, does 9 go in 3 table? Yes. Does 12 go in 3 table? Yes. So 3 is the next common factor. So 3 into 3 is 9 and 3 into 4 is 12. Now further, can these numbers be divided by a common factor? No. So we keep it as it is. Now we check the numbers which are here. So which numbers are there? 2, 2 and 3. Now we have to multiply these numbers. 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 3. So 2 into 2 is 4. 4 into 3 is 12. So the highest common factor of 36 and 48 is 12. Okay? So in this way, we find the least common multiple or the lowest common multiple of given two numbers and the highest common factor of given two numbers. So I hope you have understood this, how to find the LCM and HCF of given numbers. These are a few examples which I have solved, but in the notes I have solved more examples. So once you practice those and once you practice the homework sums also, you will get a better idea of how to find the HCF and LCM. Okay, so that is it for today. We will meet in the next class, students. Till then, take care. Goodbye.